I'm TJ Manotok, and this is your TFC News Now.
We begin with the legal woes of former U.S. President Donald Trump. Despite the New York judge ordering him to pay up to $355 million in a civil fraud trial, analysts still believe he will cruise his way to victory to the Republican presidential nomination. Watchers say his base and Republican-leaning voters remain convinced Trump is facing a witch hunt, following his previous indictments, which were supported by evidence of alleged wrongdoings. Filipino-American professor Jay Gonzalez of the Golden Gate University says there seems to be no convincing Trump supporters otherwise.
Even though President Biden's, the U.S. economy is actually doing very well. We have low unemployment, we have low inflation, we have rising income. But in their world, that's not the story.
For Ron Falcone, Filipino-American Republican mayor of Brunswick, Ohio, he sees the clear sentiments of his constituents the same as most of Republicans across the country. Trump is still the best choice to make America great again.
It's not just people here where I live, but I mean people in American cities, you know, throughout our country. And they see the problems that this administration has exacerbated over the past 4 years. And they don't want that anymore.
Trump remains in the lead in the delegate count for the GOP nomination. His next stop is for yet another primary this week, this time in South Carolina, the home state of his remaining rival, former Governor Nikki Haley. Next, we head to Virginia, where a preserved copy of the Philippine Declaration of Independence was recently unveiled to the public. The 1899 document was a gift to General Douglas MacArthur and was found in the past years by the archivists of his memorial under a collection of donated items. Donors from around the world had chipped in to help restore the copy in good condition. The unveiling in Norfolk coincided with an event to mark the 125th anniversary of the Philippine-American War. Military historian Jeffrey Acosta says the long history between the Philippines and the U.S. needs to be remembered, as he adds that very few Americans know about it.
What we're doing as a remembrance is to get and bring to the consciousness of Americans. This war is not remembered very well in any of our educational systems here in the United States.
And finally to California, where Filipino chefs are living the dream in Michelin-starred and James Beard Award-winning restaurants. In the decade since opening up Republic in Los Angeles, many of the Manzke restaurant group chefs have made major moves in the global food industry. The marriage between Walter Manzke and Filipina chef Margarita Lorenzana has since turned into the Manzke Restaurant Empire, in a chain of 20 and counting wildflower bakery and cafe branches in the Philippines. Chefs at the restaurant group share that Manzke has helped elevate Filipino cuisine to the international level.
15 years ago, Filipino food was very unknown. If it was, it was very misunderstood in the States and elsewhere. So when people would ask me what my goals were as a chef, it was always two things. It was one, to bring Filipino food into the forefront, at least here, or go home to the Philippines and cook, and cook food that I learned here. And I think our setup, while it wasn't intentional, that's basically what happened.
The restaurant group hopes to continue that elevation this year as the chefs look to gain more experience and awards no matter which restaurant they will serve at.
And those are the stories making the headlines. For more of our TFC News, log on to our website, news.abs-cbn.com/tfcnews. Head over to our YouTube channel of the ABS-CBN News channel and download the ABS-CBN News app for your smartphones and tablets. I'm TJ Manotok. Stay with us, Kapamilya.